In this video, you're going to learn how to create a leaf print. So first, you're going to need to gather some leaves and gather a variety of leaves, so different shapes, sizes, things that will create an interesting composition. You're also going to need some half sheets of white paper, and these are to make sure you don't get paint everywhere. I used black tempera paint, but you can also use black acrylic paint. So I'm going to get my brayer rolled in my ink or my tempera or acrylic paint, and then placing my leaf on top of one of the white sheets of paper, I'm going to roll the ink evenly on. Notice I'm going over it again and again to make sure that the paint completely covers the leaves. Once I've got it good and covered, I'm going to turn the leaf upside down, and then I'm going to take another piece of paper and I'm gonna place it on the back and rub, rub, rub until all that paint gets on my paper. Then I gently lift it up and I start again. And the piece of paper that I just used, I can reuse that for my underneath paper this time. If you want, you could also try using white paint with black construction paper as a background or any kind of dark colored construction paper would look good with white paint. So again, you're just gonna lay a piece of paper on top before you start pressing with your fingers, otherwise you would make a huge mess. And I keep on reusing that piece of paper. So anytime I press on the back of a leaf, I'm gonna use that as my underneath paper for the next go round. You wanna make sure that your leaf is completely covered, because as you can see, the entire leaf does not print. You're gonna get some areas that are left white, but that creates texture in the leaf. So we want that texture. But you won't get the texture if you don't cover the entire leaf with paint. So you have to make sure that the entire leaf is completely black before you decide to print. Now you can play around with printing from the front side of the leaf or the back side and see if you get different textures, see if the lines stand out more one way or the other. So as you're gonna see right now, I'm gonna reuse that same leaf, but I am rolling paint on the back side. So you're gonna see the difference between a print made from the front of a leaf versus a print made from the back of that same leaf. All right, so as you can see, the second print turned out a little bit better, and that was made from the back of the leaf. So you want to fill up your paper with as many leaf prints as you can, using different sizes and shapes. You don't want your paper to look cluttered, so you definitely don't want to overlap your prints, but you want to make good use of the space on your paper. And after you create your last leaf print, you're going to come up with a really, really interesting way to fill up the rest of the space on your paper. So you're not going to leave the background of the paper white. You're going to add some kind of a design. Might be a repeating design. It might be a painted design. It might be something that you do with Sharpies, pens, colored pencils. You might use a Q-tip and dip it in paint to add patterns to the background. You might use a toothpick with paint to add dots all over the place. Come up with something unique and interesting to finish your composition. So again, make sure that you fill up as much space as you can on your paper without cluttering the page. You want to leave some negative space, so some white space, which is also called negative space, for you to add a pattern in for the very last step. I hope you guys enjoy making your leaf prints, and I can't wait to see what you come up with.